Good morning, Dr. Rachael. My name is Arthur. I'm from Columbus, Ohio. And my question to you is this. Oh, first, let me start off by saying I really appreciate your videos. You're very helpful. I think you're wonderful. I'm very helpful for the community. Thank you. My question is, can I reverse the endothelial dysfunction? I started exercising. I have changed my diet a little. And my routine is a lot different now. But I'm wondering, what is your take on reversing and maybe getting control of the endothelial dysfunction?
Great question.
Is it a lot of pumping? Is it medic? Is it, would I be the one?
I noticed when he said, is it a lot of pumping? You know, his face just got to the point where he's like, please don't tell me that that's what I have to do. But let's talk about
it. Or I just have medication, or I don't truly understand. But I'm pretty sure, amazing as you are, you know the answer to this. My name is Arthur. I appreciate you and answer at your earliest convenience. Thank you.
Awesome, Arthur. I love it. So thank you, Arthur, for sending that question in, because I think a lot of people are wondering the exact same thing. So let's first just dive into what is endothelial cell dysfunction. So basically, every blood vessel in your body is lined with something called the endothelium, which are basically cells that decide how healthy these blood vessels are going to be. So endothelial cell dysfunction is something that the majority of us will run into at some point in our lives. It's fueled by inflammation, so different foods that we're eating. It's fueled by inactivity, so not moving as much. And really, when we want to think about repairing it, first of all, we've got to fix what caused it in the first place, right? So in Arthur's situation, probably some of it has to do with diet. Some of it has to do with him working so hard that he's probably not exercising. Another part is that working and supporting family, you know, it can be stressful. So stress can be a part of that. So we want to try to manage all of that. We want to look at your blood sugar. How can we get your blood sugar regulated? How can we get the foods that are in there that are packed with antioxidants? That's what people are doing with the smoothie recipes. But also, taking it one step further, what can we do to repair and kind of enhance your body's ability to make nitric oxide? Because we talk about nitric oxide in terms of erectile strength, but actually nitric oxide is such an amazing molecule that it is responsible for our immune function, it is responsible for blood flow, our blood pressure, and honestly, over time, when we look at it, every decade of life, our bodies are making less and less nitric oxide. So honestly, one of the best things that you can do to start to repair the endothelium and the lining of your blood vessels is to support your nitric oxide pathway. And what I mean by that is there's two different pathways, two different ways you can support your body's ability to make nitric oxide. And the first way that you can do that is by supplementing things like L-citrulline or L-arginine, right? These are part of the pathway that our body uses to make nitric oxide. But there's a very special other way that we're doing it. So as we age, that pathway that I just mentioned, the L-arginine and L-citrulline pathway, our body's ability to use that pathway decreases as we age. So in your 20s and 30s and maybe even 40s, taking L-citrulline and L-arginine to boost nitric oxide production likely helps and works. But as you start to age 50s, 60s, 70s, 80s, that pathway is really hard. We can pump in L-arginine and L-citrulline all day long, and it might not make any difference because the endothelium might not know what to do with all of that, right? Your body might not process that well enough. So with that being the case, our next step is to focus on things we can do, right? The other pathway of nitric oxide production comes from what we eat, what we're ingesting orally. So this goes back to our conversation around mouthwash. This goes back to our conversation around increasing green leafy vegetables and nitrate-rich foods, because we're not just theoretically saying this. There's science to back up the fact that the minute that you ingest green leafy vegetables or nitrate-rich food, if your body can process that and reduce it to nitrites and absorb it in your body, well, bam, now we have more substances for your body to make nitric oxide, which then causes a repair of the elasticity of your blood vessels. It causes basically that whole concept of endothelial cell dysfunction. Now we're starting to function again. So I see it all the time where I have guys who come in and pretty much the medication that they've started with has stopped, whether that's Viagra, whether it's the Trimix, whether that's the gas station pill, what have you. And honestly, with those guys, sometimes the biggest thing is nitric oxide production. If we can get the endothelial cells back functioning, the blood vessels back healthier, then everything changes. Not just the erections change, but hypertension goes down. We have better control over diabetes. We lose weight quicker and so on and so forth. But also a part of that, getting your endothelial cells back repaired, if you're a gentleman and you're aging, is making sure your testosterone levels are good. Because when your testosterone levels dip down, also this contributes to this process of endothelial cell dysfunction and our body's inability to make nitric oxide. Now, the interesting thing about nitric oxide production is that in women and men, hey, everybody needs it. If we could boost everybody's nitric oxide levels right now, today, I bet you some of you would come off of blood pressure medicine. Some of you would feel great. Your wrinkles would start to go away. Nitric oxide is really that important. And there's nothing that you can take to just give you nitric oxide. You really have to try to support your body's ability to make more nitric oxide. And that's essential to this process of endothelial cell repair. So if you want to repair your endothelium, you have to stop smoking, you have to stop drinking. That's a big thing. You got to cut down on processed foods and eat more natural organic foods, right? We got to cut out the sugary drinks. We got to move more. And I think a big thing that we don't talk about enough is you got to get at least 6.5 hours of sleep a night. Yes, at least 6.5 hours of sleep at night, so that your body has the opportunity to regenerate. So sleep and rest, you know, we abuse it a little bit, but that is the time during the day that your body is designed to repair itself. Yeah. This great thing that God gave us is designed to really heal itself, and it cannot heal itself. It cannot do its job if it doesn't have rest. And when we talk sometimes about intermittent fasting and fasting, that's partially why fasting can be so powerful for some people, because you're putting your body into this rest state so that your body doesn't have to decide what to do with food. Your body doesn't have to decide to do with the stress of somebody yelling at you, or it doesn't have to decide what to do about something you saw on social media. It is absolutely resting. So I say that to say that you got to get enough rest when it comes to repairing anything. Okay. So that's a great question. Awesome.